break.
What is happening, guys? Raven here, bringing you another Genshin Impact video. In today's video, we are gonna take a look at the new 4-star that will be coming in 1.5, called Yanfei.
Yeah, boy.
She will be available on the Zhongli rerun banner. First, let's take a look at her abilities. Her normal attack deals pyro damage. When they hit the enemies, she will receive a Scarlet Seal. She may have up to 3 Scarlet Seals, 4 if you have her at C6, which we will talk about a bit later. Each seal will decrease her stamina consumption and they will disappear when she leaves the field. Her charge attack will consume 50 stamina and all her seals that she currently has, dealing AoE pyro damage. The damage scales on how many seals she has when using the charge attack. Her E is called Sign Edict. She summons blistering flames, dealing AoE pyro damage. Opponents hit by her E will grant her the maximum numbers of Scarlet Seals. The cooldown of her elemental skill is 9 seconds. Her elemental burst is called Undeal. Her ult is like an explosion, dealing AoE pyro damage and granting her the maximum amount of Scarlet Stacks. At the end, applying Brilliance to her. This one has two effects. The first one grants her a Scarlet Seal at fixed intervals. The second one increases the damage dealt by her charge attack. This effect will end if she dies or you switch her out. So, after reading her abilities, she reminds me of another 4-star that we have in the game, which is Geomama Ningguang. Both their playstyles are pretty similar. They are based around the charge attack. So, you want to play her as a build and spend, because both her E and ult grants her the max amount of seals. The full rotation, it will be like this. 3 times her normal attack, then a charge attack, followed by an E spell. Then, charge attack again, followed by an ult. Then lastly, one more charge attack.
Are you sure about that?
Yes.
Before I forget, here is a list with all her talent books and materials required to ascend her to level 9. Now, let's take a look at her talents. The first one is not that important, so I'll just skip it. The second one is called Proviso. Each Scarlet Seal that she consumes by using her charge attack will grant her a 5% pyro damage bonus. This effect lasts for 6 seconds. So in total, you will get a 50% bonus pyro damage at C0. 5% for each seal that you have at the moment. This effect cannot stack. So, if you use a 3 seal charge attack again, the buff will refresh. So you cannot exceed the 50% bonus at C0. The last one is called Blazing Eye. When her charge attack deals a critical hit, she will deal additional AoE pyro damage, equal to 80% of her attack. This damage counts as charge attack damage, so it scales with her normal attack talent's level. By reading this talent, you will want to have attack percentage on her artifacts, because she scales really well with that stat. The last thing that we need to talk about in this section are her constellations. You will need both her C1 and C6 in order for your charge attacks to not consume any stamina. Plus, her C6 will grant her another seal, which is a damage increase across the board for her. Her C2 is a nice boost to her crit rate when your enemies are below 50%. The C4, however, is a bit interesting. She will get a shield that will absorb 45% of her max HP after she uses her ult. Here, the text doesn't mention a cooldown on her C4. So for now, let's say that every time she uses her ult, the shield is generated. One more important thing to note here. The text description on her ult energy cost is absent on the Honey Hunter website. So, from the leaks that I saw, her ult will have an 80 energy cost.
Damn!
Which is massive. We still have to wait for the live version in order to see if this is true or not. Let's speculate and say that the energy cost is 80. If that's the case, then you'll need a lot of energy recharge on her to be able to use her ult frequently. That's all that I have to say about her constellations. Now let's move on to the more interesting part, which is builds and weapons. The two best 5 stars for her are gonna be the Skyward Atlas and the Lost Prayer of the Sacred Winds. Memory of Drast, it's only good in my opinion if you have her at C4, because you will be able to get the full benefit without having a shield character in your team. Plus, it will increase your shield strength that the C4 provides. But this one is a maybe.
Maybe?
As for the 4th star, the best will be the Witsit. All the 3 buffs that the weapon provides are very good for her. If you have the weapon at higher requirements, this will be even better. Plus, the weapon gives crit damage, which is a good stat. Another good weapon for her will be the Sacrificial Fragment.
What?
Hear me out here. This will only work if you have the weapon at higher requirements, to get a higher chance of her elemental skill to reset. Keep in mind that her playstyle is based on building shields and then spending them on her charge attacks. Plus, if you paid attention when I mentioned her E ability, you should know that her elemental skill will give her the max amount of seals. So, if you get more resets on her E, you can spam your charge attacks more often. That's why I consider this weapon to be viable for her. The last 4 star weapon will be Solar Pearl. I only consider this weapon because of the crit rate that the weapon provides. Plus, the weapon effect will be okay on her. These are the best weapons that I will use on her. But at the end of the day, you are going to use what you have. Even if you do not have any of the weapons that I mentioned above, a good replacement will be the Blacktiff Agate. You can buy one using 20 Masterless Star Glitter from the Pyman Shop. That's all for the weapons section. Now let's take a look at some builds for her. There are only 3 builds that I recommend using for her. The first one is gonna be 4 pieces Crimson Witch of Flames. This is the go-to set for maximizing her damage. Additionally, the 4 piece bonus set will increase the Overlord, Vaporize and Melt damage if you are gonna use her in a elemental reaction comp, which you should, since she is a pyro character. I will go in more details about this in the team comp section. Next, we have the Wanderer's Troop 4-piece set. This one is a good replacement if you do not have a 4-piece Chrismon Witch set or you have bad stats on them. The 8 Elemental Mastery and 35% charge attack bonus that both the 2 and the 4 pieces provide are very good on her. The last set that I'm going to talk about is the 4 pieces Retracing Bowline. Now, you are gonna wonder, what is this guy smoking?
This shit good!
This set will only work on her if you have her at C4 or you have a character like Zhongli or Diona to give her a shield. Do not build this set if you do not have her at C4 or a character in your party that can shield her. You will lose damage in that case, which is not good. That's all for the builds that I see viable on her. I didn't include a set like Noblesse because we still don't know for sure what's the energy cost of her ult. If her ult is 80 energy, then you will have a hard time casting ult after ult to get the bonus that the top piece Noblesse provides. Lastly, let's talk about some characters that will be doing good with her. Since she is a pyro user, you will want to run her with characters like Xingqiu, Mona in a vaporized camp. Kea, Rosaria, Diona, even Ganyu for her ult into a melee camp. Maybe Fischl if you want to do loads of overload damage. She can be played in a lot of teams. Here are some examples. Zhongli, Bennett, Xingqiu and Yanfei. Zhongli because he's the Geodaddy, his shield is OP. Plus, characters protected by his JS shield will decrease the enemy both physical and elemental resistance by 20%. That equals more pyro damage for her. Bennett for his attack buff and the Pyro Resonance, and Xingqiu for the Vaporize damage. Another example will be Zhongli, Bennett and Kea, or any other Cryo character for doing the Melt Elemental Reaction. you get the gist by now. She can be played in a lot of comps. Here are my final thoughts about Yanfei. Her playstyle is similar with Ningguo. She relies a lot on her charge attacks. Without her C6, she'll consume some stamina after each charge attack. She does not require Constellation, but her lack of stamina after each charge attack will result in some DPS loss. She cannot be swapped in the middle of her burst, because you will lose her value at that point. Her ult cost is still unknown, we will see at release. If her ult is 80 energy cast, then you will need a lot of energy recharge or a dedicated power or battery for her, in order to use her burst after. She does not have supportive capabilities. That's all that I have to say about the new pyro user Yanfei. To me, she looks like an Ingwan reskin. The only difference being that she is a pyro user, which will do more damage. But that's only my opinion. I want to hear your guys' opinion on her. What do you think about her and how you will build her? Tell me in the comment section down below. My name is RevanX. If you find this video helpful, leave a like and subscribe to my channel. Thank you all for watching, and I'll be seeing you in the next one. Peace.